All right, everybody, this is Brian Smith with the Who's Next Football Recruiting Podcast, and I am here with Jennifer Jackson, the mother of Sam Jackson, offensive lineman for the UCF Knights. Ms. Jackson, I appreciate you coming on the show. Thank you very much for coming on today.
Thank you for having me, Brian.
Absolutely. Football is a part of your family's life. I know earlier when we talked on the phone, you mentioned that Sam started to fall in love with football when he was a really small kid, 3 years old. Obviously, he's much bigger now. He's about 320, 330, something like that. Explain what it's like being a mom growing up in Florida. You're in the Bradenton area. For those who don't know, Bradenton, Sarasota area, Lakewood Ranch. What it's like taking a kid all the time to practices, to combines, whatever it is. What's that like from a culture standpoint?
Well, if you love football the way I do, and the way Sam does, it's just as simple as brushing your teeth. It's just what you do. I will say, I mean, at the age of three, I took him to an arena football game, and he told me then that he wanted to play football. So, you know, he watched me coach the Bucks from the couch for quite some time. They didn't listen very well. But then, you know, as he grew up, he was too heavy for pads whenever he was like after seven. So he joined Manatee Bulls, which is like a non-weight football program. And he started that in the seventh grade. And, you know, at that point, I just knew he loved it. As long as he wanted to do it, I was going to be, you know, willing to travel and do whatever he needed to do. And I was the team mom, actually the business manager, if you will. That's what the kids called me. So I was on the sidelines for all of that. And a great experience. I got to mom a lot of kids, which was it was wonderful for me. It just really, I don't know, it changed my viewpoint even more so about football. And then in high school, it was a no-brainer. Once he hit varsity, he started varsity in the ninth grade, and we traveled to all the camps, you know, Rivals. At the time, it was Nike Spark, and I think they changed the name of that. Yeah, so we went to the FAMU camp. We went to a lot of different things, but doing it was like, I mean, I lived for it. I miss those days, actually.
No, that's really cool. A lot of people, it's hard for even me I'm married to recruiting and football. That's just who I am. Most people don't understand it. So it's good that you're presenting it from a mother's perspective, because not all parents, the money in particular, really enjoy it, because it is expensive. Hotels, rental cars, whatever it is, plane flights. It can be a lot of different things. And of course, the clothing and the gear and the gas, et cetera. So good for you. By the way, this podcast, I put it as like team mom, Jennifer. You know, I got that vibe from you earlier that it was a fit. So I think I've done well with that.
You did.
anyway,
mom squad.
That's right. Well, we'll talk about that here in a minute, the mom squad for UCF football. Speaking of the Knights, I put up a post earlier today on Twitter, best game in the last 10 years, just from a viewer, spectator standpoint, UCF football. And I got a lot of different answers. Probably the number one was the USF-UCF game in 2017. I guess it just went back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And those are fun games. From your experience, and again, your parents, it's a little different. What's the best game atmosphere for UCF you've been associated with?
Well, basically any home game is crazy. Not last year so much, but because of COVID. But when the bounce house is full and everybody's, you know, on the same page, and whether we're winning or not, like that particular game was crazy. I remember it. I will say I don't know if that was our conference game. I don't think so. I think we played Memphis for our conference game that year. I can't quite remember, but that was very exciting. I remember, you know, coming down from my seats and walking around the stadium because we were going to be able to go on the field once we won. And we were just that close, and we hit it at the last minute. So that was exciting. And of course, the Peach Bowl. That's my favorite.
Sure.
Yeah. I mean,
self-explanatory, of course. Yeah. Nothing wrong with that.
No.
As far as being a parent at the games, I'm sure it's a little bit different because you're following your kid. But seeing the stadium, seeing it live, were you surprised when you first started going to college football games? I know it's your kid on the sidelines, but like, how many people are into college football? Did that take you off guard?
Well, definitely, because I had watched NFL my whole life, and I thought that was exciting, even if I was watching it from home, because I didn't, you know, I didn't have season tickets to the Bucks or anything. But and that's a family thing. My sister, we would watch it together, my nephew. But when we went to 6 home games at UCF before Sam ever committed, and that was our first taste of it. But once he hit that field, it was it just I don't know. I started watching other teams on Saturday as well. Like, I would, you know, if there were no games at all, I might check out a different team, because college football, there's nothing like it. It's special. Sure. I mean, if he could play it for the rest of his life, I'd be happy.
Doesn't pay that well. That's cool. What's it like for a parent? And I know a few of you travel, talk about which ones that do, to go to road games, watch Sam, watch the team. What's the experience like before, after, etc.? Explain that for people out there.
Well, it's definitely a family. Over the years, we've, you know, we as new parents come in, we get to know them, you know, make sure that they, you know, are welcomed in and part of the family. But I travel with Alex Ward's parents, Jim and Allison. I used to travel with the Barnes's, were part of it, Dylan Barnes's parents, but he's since graduated and plays for Predators. The Gabriels, I travel with them as well. And of course, when Teresa Milton was here, I traveled with her. So for all of us, we would, you know, we would coordinate when we were going to fly, not necessarily on the same flight, get to the hotel before the boys, maybe a day or two before. And, you know, we'd do some sightseeing or just hang out and, you know, spend time together. And then when the guys would get there on, say, the game's on Saturday, they fly in on Friday, we'd be outside the hotel cheering them on and being the welcoming committee. So, but there are a lot of parents that travel, so for sure.
Is it pretty much every game like that, or is it just like, you know, the bigger games like Cincinnati or Memphis or something?
Every game. I haven't missed one yet. So, and
oh wow, that's impressive. Of course,
yeah, the Alex Wards, I mean, the Wards, they definitely go. I mean, when the Barneses were here, they went to all the games. Tyler Paul's mom, she goes to everything. So there's really quite a few parents, and of course the Gabriels, they go. But we don't miss. We've already got all of our hotels booked for this season. We're staying where the players are, and then all of our flights are already booked. So, yeah.
There you go. There you go. Well, I'm doing a trip up to Louisville, a fan interaction thing. I think you know about that. So I'll have to have you on for that too. But
I've already told all the parents about it. That's what we're doing Thursday night. So,
you know, there we go. I'm looking forward to it. I think the Louisville fans will come out and support. It'll be cool.
It'll be fine. I was looking for the location, but I think you said that would be later.
Yeah, we think we know, but until it's in writing, I'm not posting anything. I've learned the hard way. Yeah. I've learned the hard way with stuff like that. Restaurants, bars, and stuff.
Yeah.
They can change owners tomorrow. So right. I'll wait.
Exactly.
I'll wait. How has football brought you and your son closer together?
Well, I raised both of my kids by myself, not bragging about that, just making a statement. And I would say when they both played football, his brother played as well when they were little. And it just, I mean, you know, for a kid to be at a game at 5 years old or 13 or, you know, now 22, and to know that their parent is part of that out there cheering them on and, you know, just helping them achieve whatever goals and dreams they have is, it's like nothing else. Like, I don't know. I wish I could put it in a bottle, because I could probably make a gazillion dollars. But the three of us are very close for sure.
I'll help you with the patent. We'll retire and earn 15% on the beach. How's that?
Yes, sounds good.
Describe the relationship since they've gotten to UCF with Kristi and Gus Malzahn, as far as them, not just with your son, but with the other parents, players. What's it like with being around them?
I'm from South Georgia, and Kristi is very Southern. I don't know where she's from, but she's definitely, I'm very outspoken, and she is. So it's like, it's just like having senior parents, you know, their parents over all the parents and over all the players. They really care about the kids. You knew that right away. Of course, you know, in February, we were all worried about, oh my gosh, who are we going to get? You know, this is our third time. And, you know, we loved Scott Frost, nothing against the second group of coaches, because they were okay too. But, you know, we leveled up. And Gus, he really cares about these kids, not only from a personal level, but he business-wise, you know, like if they want to go to the NFL, I mean, he's got connections for days. Sam's O-line coach, Herb Hand, my first experience with him was an hour on the phone. We talked football. We talked everything. And you just don't get that in every group. I mean, when Frost was here, I was very close to the O-line coach and to Frost. I mean, got to know him like, you know, like they were my brothers, I guess, is the best way to put it.
So, excellent. Yeah. Well, I've heard good things about Gus and Kristi, and I was actually messaging with Kristi earlier today regards to like which parents like to cook and different things. She's just a normal person. She's not, because they've got money and they're millionaires. She didn't come across that way at all.
Zero.
Those are the that believe me, that is not always the case.
Oh, yeah. I did tell you I'm on my third set of coaches, so
Yeah, I'm sure you've seen a little of everything.
Yeah, for sure. And, you know, they are like, we just had ladies night and it was, I've been to it every year, but it was a really warm family atmosphere, even though there were, you know, a lot of different people there. It wasn't just parents, of course. A lot of parents didn't make it, but they're just great people. I'm just so excited about the season. I can't wait. I can't wait to see, because what they display, what Gus displays, and how he lets her be involved, and how they're going to, how he's going to transfer that to these football players. Already he's doing that. It's going to be an exciting year. Our fans are going to be surprised at the team that we have, in my opinion.
So. Oh, that's what college football is about.
Yeah.
Your opinion is just as valid as anybody else. What's it like sort of being the team mom, like your son, this is his fifth year in the program. There's not much you probably haven't seen, whether it's on the gridiron, the practices. You've told me you go to practices, et cetera. What's it kind of like mentoring some of the other parents that have players on the team?
Well, I'm definitely that mom. If I'm on the practice field and we have recruits coming in, they kind of like, you know, are they'll stand off, you know, to the side. Maybe they'll be with other parents. But most of the time, I make my way over, because I know that for me, I didn't have that. And I like the fact that, in case I have any questions, because, you know, Sam's first offer was University of Miami. I mean, it's not a bad school. Obviously, it's a great school. But there's something special about UCF, and I really can't, I mean, I can't just pin it down to one thing. And I want those parents to know it. I'm not trying to convince their kid to come. I'm just letting the parents know, hey, this is what we have. I'm not benefiting at all by telling you any of this, but if you want to know from a parent's perspective why we came here and, you know, what your son would get. You live 1,000 miles away. I moved here when Sam came over, so I'm lucky. But, yeah, it's just that's what we do on the field for practice. That's what I do on the field for practice.
That's awesome. Yeah, it's good, because a lot of parents have no idea where recruiting is or what it's like when the kid first gets there. So it's nice to have somebody to kind of help the process along.
Yeah.
What about college football in general? You mentioned a few minutes ago that when you have, you know, UCF is off, you watch some football now. Has, you know, this just in your blood now, where you watch football? If it's like you flip the channels, oh, there's a game on Fox or ESPN or NBC, whatever. Do you stop and watch it? Has it gotten you to that point?
I will rewatch UCF football games from years past.
Okay.
Before I will watch, I don't know, the Gators. Okay.
Sure.
If I'm not doing anything, I like it. I like it just, I don't know, the strategy, the, you know, to watch the players and see what they do. And it's, I don't know. So yeah, I guess if I'm flipping through the channels and there's a game on, I might watch it, but specifically, you know, like Mackenzie's at FSU, that's not my team, but it is now for this year. And will sure. I watch that? Absolutely. I'll watch it just so I can see him. Or if I know, I mean, I have a friend, his son's on Marshall. If Marshall's game's on TV and I see it, you know, my friend lets me know he's playing, I'll catch that as well. So.
Well, you're loyal then. There's nothing wrong with having friendships beyond UCF after a player moves along like Mackenzie Milton. So that's awesome. Okay, recruiting. Sam got his first offer from Miami. How far in was it before UCF really got involved and extended a scholarship offer to your son?
Well, Sam got that offer. You know, they're not supposed to talk to him until the 11th grade. We went to a camp in between 10th and 11th grade. So that's when he got his first offer from Miami. And then we went for recruiting weekend and, you know, the hands changed. That was that terrible Clemson-Miami game, 42-0. Al Golden lost his job the next day. So that was pretty surreal. But we, you know, I'm not saying Sam knew that he wasn't going to go there. He just had other offers. So, you know, we check it out. But then spring of his 11th grade, his head coach took him and a couple other players to a UCF spring practice. Okay. And Coach Frost and G were here, Coach G. And they didn't offer him. Coach G didn't offer him that day, but he called the next day and made him an offer. So it was, yeah, it was pretty fast. And then, I mean, there were other offers like Oklahoma, something in Indiana, USF, bless their hearts. They tried their best. But, yeah, this was UCF was there was just something there. Sam went to the Army All-American Combine in, I think, in 11th grade. And we happened to be on our flight back. John Gruden was on our flight. And we happened to be standing in line next to him. And we started talking football. And John told him, he said, Sam, find a school where if you didn't have football, you would like the environment, that you would like the, you know, the educational process. And again, I mean, of course, we're glad for football, but there's just something magical here. And it's not Disney. Okay, so for
touché.
Sure. Yeah.
Touché, especially yeah. Driving by Disney.
Oh,
that's one of my least favorite things in the world, but I digress.
Yes.
All right, now for a little lighter side. Okay. You can apply this to parent or player, perhaps both. Funniest player or funniest coach, funniest team mom, whatever you want to do. If you want to share a little anecdote, feel free.
Okay, so I think Coach T will that we got from, oh my gosh, he's special. He is definitely special. That's all I can say. I love him. I love what he posts. Funniest parent, that's got to be me. I mean, I'm the comedian.
What promotion. I love it.
Yeah. Well, you know, the comedian of the group. And I don't know, player-wise, I mean, I didn't know my son did headstands on the field, but I don't know if he's doing that to be funny, but otherwise, I don't know. I mean, I don't really know any of the guys to be humorous, if you will. So
that's all right. T. Will is a mile a second kind of guy. When I first met him, like, he was just ready to jump through his skin. So, yeah, that's just his personality on the daily. He really likes being around UCF, and he's pretty excited. So I'm not surprised that you mentioned him.
Yeah,
he's a special character. Best road trip that you've taken? You said you've been to all the games. What would you say, if you could single it out to one, great, if not two or three that you've been on, in terms of just the entire, you know, the game, the scenery, the whole nine yards?
New Orleans was the best. I had never been there. Yeah, and that was awesome. I had never walked that much in my entire life.
It's hard to get around New Orleans. I've been there numerous times.
Oh, my gosh. Nobody told me, like, the parents that I was with, they'd been there before. So I didn't realize, first of all, that the sidewalks and the road, that everything's still uneven. I didn't wear tennis shoes, and we walked. Mm-hmm. We literally walked like 11, 12 miles the first day because we went everywhere. Yeah, that was before the game, you know. I'm not going to say, I don't know, if you probably didn't ask this, but I will tell you, worst experience was Georgia Tech because it was like a 2-mile walk to the stadium, and then they put us up in the nosebleed section.
Yeah, that's typical for major programs. It'll be a corner, and that's the end of the story. I don't know one that doesn't do it that way. I've traveled to a lot of stadiums watching teams.
Yeah.
Every team usually gets that.
We don't mind the corner. We just didn't. I mean, there were some senior people that came to that game, and there were no rails going to the top. But, you know.
That's a whole nother animal there. That's
not kind of crazy, but yeah, I'd say New Orleans was my favorite. Peach Bowl was my favorite. My sister lives in Atlanta, but just the experience itself was just awesome. And I don't know where we were. Well, the Martin Luther King Museum, we went to that.
Sure.
That was last year. That was pretty surreal. I'm not going to say it was my favorite thing was very enlightening and heartbreaking, but it was a good experience for the parents, because the Powells, that was the other group of parents. And I was gonna, when I send you some people that maybe want to talk to, they're great people too. And they travel with us as well. So we got to experience that Martin Luther King Museum.
One last question. Out of all the families and stuff that you travel with, you've mentioned multiple times to me that the Gabriels are part of it. Obviously, Dylan is a very talented football player, and he's going to get paid to play his favorite sport. What is it like traveling with them, and what's something that people may or may not know about them, because you get to know them on a different level than just about anybody else?
Okay, well, they're incredibly humble people, and, you know, as Hawaiians are, it's Ohana. So Dylan and his brother live here. They have a place, and I'm very close. Actually, his brother is my other travel partner, Garrison. So I know them intimately. Dory calls me, Dylan's mom calls me once a week, once every 2 weeks, or I call her. But, you know, I wear Sam's jersey. They don't wear Dylan's jersey. They're very low-key. And I guess as a quarterback parent, because we kind of talked about it, I probably wouldn't either, because, you know, it's bad enough if you hear somebody say anything about the O-line, which they don't do too often, but not to me anyway. But as a quarterback, you know, they get all the nasty stuff.
So. Highs and low. There's no in between with quarterback. Right. It's just the way it is.
Exactly. But they're wonderful people. They are, I mean, they're just loving. They have a younger son, Roman. And of course, like I said, Garrison that I travel with, and what you see is what you get. I mean, they're just very kind, warm, you know, grateful and humble people. You know, like Dylan's a great quarterback, but there's never any of that chest beating or, oh, that's my son and he's all that in a bag of chips. Never. It's always about, how's your son doing? Like Dory always asks me about my kids when she calls, you know, she loves Sam. You know, she checks on me. Like it's that kind of relationship. So yeah, they're great people.
That's great, because I know from experience from other places that I've covered stuff, I've covered Notre Dame, I've helped the LSU side, Clemson, different things. It doesn't matter the school, the quarterback can throw 30 touchdowns in 10 games. If he throws a pick, he's going to get cussed. That's the end of the story. There is no in between.
Yeah.
It does not matter. Plus, there's this thing called alcohol that's at stadium. So,
yeah. Some people come pretty buzzed. And if they're sitting close to the parent section, I don't know.
Yeah. I remember a few years ago, there was a game and Pittsburgh was playing Notre Dame and they had this thing going up, like just stairs and waiting for fans to go up. And it showed the parents of the quarterback for, I don't remember who he was, like 5-8 years ago. And they would stay out there. He wasn't that great. He was just a mediocre Division I quarterback, but he's still a Division I quarterback. Sure. He got booed and cussed so much, the parents wouldn't physically come in the stadium. It's kind of an angle. They could see everything, but they didn't really hear.
Yeah.
And that's how they dealt with it.
Yeah.
Like, wow, that's got to be really hard. I'm like, wow.
Yeah.
But yeah. You know what? He got a free education. It is what it is. So I'm sure some booster probably helped him get a pretty good job too. So
yeah, of course.
Absolutely. Well, Jennifer, I appreciate you coming on. Thank you very much. We are right around the corner from football season. Actually, tomorrow I'll see Gus and Sam, actually, media day. For those fans out there that do not know, the Knights will have their media day tomorrow. It starts at 11 a.m. I'll be over in Orlando making the trek from Tampa. I tell you what, it's pretty interesting, because I've got like a short list of questions that I want to ask. And I'm kind of, before I even write them down, I just got some like chicken scratches and stuff. There's so many things to ask him. He's probably going to get overwhelmed just with me, because new offense, new style, new coaching style, new personality. I've heard totally different things about his personality and all that. And then you got guys like Sam coming back. I'm curious to get to know some of them. It's going to be a lot of fun. So I'm going to put up a lot of information. Your podcast will actually go in one of my stories here coming up tonight or in the morning, whichever one I get to first. I got a couple things to do, but thank you again very much. Absolutely. And I'll have you on again soon. And I hopefully get to see some of the parents before the Louisville game. I'm looking forward to that. And for those of you that don't know what I was talking about, I'm doing an event with the Louisville site, and we're going to go up. UCF plays a Friday night game. up at Louisville. We're going to do an event Thursday before the game. Some of the parents apparently are going to come. Thank you for letting me know that. I did not know, but that'll be a lot of fun too. So Inside the Knights, it's a great site, and I'm looking forward to putting some more content up. Going to be a lot of info over the next 3-4 days because I won't be able to put all of it up in one or two. I can assure you that Media Day always offers a lot. So again, thank you very much, everybody. Have a great evening. Brian Smith for Inside the Knights with Jennifer Jackson.